Hello, my name's Priscilla. I'm from Kayenta, Arizona. I teach at Kayenta Unified School District, and currently I'm a sixth grade teacher teaching regular education. I teach self-contained to 24 students. And this summer I was with Jill Campbell. The unit that I created was self-identity, and my title was Identity from the Past and the Present of Diné Nation. The purpose of my unit was to connect the students' thinking of Navajo creation story, symbolism of the Four Sacred Mountain, how the clan system works, to novels that they read. Perhaps authors and narrators allude to symbolism of like the twin warriors, how they showed their courage and how they found identity through trials and error of, you know, slaying the monsters and the journeys that they had. And so these stories are told to us when we're young. And then the clanship, we're told, and we teach kindergartners from yay high all the way to middle school. But the connection of how relevant is it to them is sort of missing. There's a gap. So my unit kind of tackles that. So we read a story and then we break it down. We analyze it and say, well, how does this create to identity? So my unit tackled that and said, if we're these four clan, why is it? Where did it originate? So the students went back to their grandparents, aunts, uncles, their interview. And lo and behold, a lot of the students came back, eyes wide open, and said, I didn't know I came from this, you know, I have a Hispanic background. I have, you know, Pacific Islander background. And they were so proud. You know, you would think like they'd be sad, but they were so proud that they had other identity other than being Navajo. And in addition, some of the girls came back understanding what puberty ceremony was really for. And that was an eye opener. I think it took the grandparents to really break it down and say, did you know this is why we do the hair tying ceremony? It's for thinking, and that's to the East. And they were saying, yeah, that's what our teacher said, you know, from the East, this is the planning time. So what I did was the four direction, I used Dr. Wilson Orana's philosophy book, and we went to the next level. And I say, okay, you always heard this in kindergarten first, all the way through elementary. This is what he's saying. This is the circle of life. When you did your interview, where about when they told you about when they were growing up, at what level do you think they were talking about? They were talking about planning. They got a career. While they were talking, I was illustrating them on the board. And all the way up to the north where they retired and now they were like grandparents and they were relaxing. And it made a lot of sense interpreting the circle of life using the four direction. Some of them never seen that. They only seen that as, oh, it's just a four direction, the four mountains, thinking, planning, and old age. That's all they looked at. That's all that was explained. But I think by going further down into it through their grandparents and their parents' interview, that connected what identity meant to them in addition. And I guess the story that we were reading, it made sense when they referred to the twin, the Navajo hero twin. It's like they knew who they were after they found the son as their father. It put them through trial and they went through so many things and they found their dad. And that's their identity. And they were saying, wow, this is what we're doing. We're finding our identity, like the twins. And I said, yeah, that's what you're doing, you know. And some of them, sad to say, they had to go through aunts and uncles to see where they came from because they don't have a mom. They don't have a dad. They're adopted. And that was sad, but in a sense, they knew they were still Navajo. And I think my unit did a good job doing that, connecting them to a family. As we know, the Navajo culture, it's written in books. Some people do presentations on it, but it's only to people that go to workshops. But it's not in the school system at full force. It can be, and the Teacher Institute will, and I think is the key, the link to the new generation parents where they are asking questions. We have a culture center in Kayenta, and many times the younger parents come because they need help how to explain their culture, because they have not really experienced it. They want to learn how to do it, but you know, something's missing. So it comes back to us in the classroom as teachers. We know how to design, how to embed culture, how to infuse it into our lesson, our content area, to make it meaningful to the children. Yes, you know, it can be simple things, simple practice, cultural practice that we embed into the daily practice of teaching. And it can be embedded into science, into social studies, into math, definitely. And I know it can be embedded into reading. In a lot of the novels, we can say, hey, this part of the story about characterization, we can compare it to the folktale of the coyote. You know, this is the character trait of this coyote. What did we learn when we were teaching that story about it? How does it relate to this novel right here? A lot of that storytelling teaching, that's not done at home anymore. Nobody does it anymore. So we take it upon us to teach those type of things. And then the history, we were talking about Manuelito and Barboncito. A lot of our students only hear the name, but they really never talk about where did they come from, what was their clan, and what were their initiative, who were they? And I think when we take these type of information and embed it into our history of our social studies and compare it to people like, you know, I was comparing some of them to like Abraham Lincoln or just anybody that's coming up in the textbook. And I say, hey, you know, we have somebody like that. You know, we had Manuelito that was always wondering, you know, we don't have to move. We don't, you know, there's so many values that we have that's just as good. And, you know, he gave up, and yeah, he went to Fort Sumner, but he stood his ground that our people are going to survive, our kids are going to get an education. Him and Barboncito and 24 leaders stood their ground. And those are things that our students don't know. And on top of it, they talk about the four direction, they talk about the culture. And even then, when all this was going on, all the cultural teaching that we still talk about, even they talk about it in the research that I did on eloquence too. So there's more than one unit that I develop, and I intertwine them when I'm doing my lessons. I think throughout the year, this is my third year, and I think the more I know, the more I study with the Teacher Institute, it's very helpful. And a lot of times the students really ask, you know, hey, Ms. Black, did you study this? Did you study that? And I'm like, not yet, but we'll get to it. You know, so the students know, and some of the parents are aware of it. Shirley and I, we were talking about during parent conference, we make parents aware of it, and they're thankful. They're like, wow, we didn't even know that. And I think it has a lot to say. And I think we really need to continue that that pull of getting everybody involved. And with my identity project, I got the grandparents involved and the parents to sit down and talk to their children and grandchildren. And I think if we do more of that, it's going to be very helpful. It's going to start filling in some gaps